Hey guys, what's up? Toby1000567 here, bringing you Merchant Guide number 4. If you want to see the previous 3, there will be a link at the end of the video that will take you right to them. And if you want to see more money making guides that are not merchanting, but item based, please go to my channel. I have about a dozen guides there, and subscribe. 2 to 3 new guides are coming out every week. So this is going to be a free to play merchanting guide. I've gotten a lot of requests to do this, and I'm going to be honest, I'm not that experienced with free to play merchanting. But I do understand the concept of it. It's just like membership or members merchanting, just with free-to-play items. I have done this. I have merchanted free-to-play quite frequently, though. So I have an item that I really do like. Go to the Grand Exchange database under Game Guides and go to search Guthix. Guthix Kite Shield is by far, in my personal opinion, a lot of people agree with me on this, is Guthix Kite Shield. Any Guthix armor is really well, but just for argument's sake, I'm just going to use Guthix Kite Shield because it seems to be the most profitable one, because everybody likes kite shields. So, as you can see by here, by the 30-day graph, this really does not apply to you unless, and this is the only reason, unless you are just flipping this merchant. So, say if you buy 10 of these in about an hour, okay, and then you flip them instantly, and then you can sell them 4 hours later. Well, if the Grand Exchange doesn't update in that time frame of, let's say, 5 hours, then this graph really doesn't apply to you at all. But if you're thinking about investing, this is the wrong video for you. This is just a quick flip merchant that you can profit off of it 2 to 3 times a day. That's what this video is for. It is not investing, it's just flip merchanting. My personal favorite, because it has very low risk next to investing. So the market price is 489K at the moment, minimum price is 465, and maximum price is 514. So that leaves us a really good profit margin, that about 40K, you know, or 50K between this and this. So that's a really high fluctuation for a free-to-play item. Now, buying and selling prices, I will tell you right now that if you did not know this, there's a 5% difference between minimum market, and there's a 5% difference between market and maximum. So what that means is that 5% of the item's value at market price is deducted off of market price, and that gives you minimum price, or added on to market price, and that gives you maximum price. If you don't really like numbers, don't worry about that. It's just me telling you what that is, how you get minimum and maximum price. So what I like to do is basically look at the chart, and let's go back here. First of all, you're gonna see change in GP today, 905. That's a very small change. That is like 1/500th of this item's total price. So you can tell that even if it goes down by 5 to 10K, you still have a really good profit margin, that you can make money off of this, and a lot of people do buy these. So what I'm going to do now is take you to a video clip that will display me buying them at a certain price that I recommend that you follow, and I will describe it there. Alright guys, so I'm at the Grand Exchange, and I got 10 million coins for demonstration purposes. Obviously you can use a lot more and a lot less, but I do recommend having enough money to buy 2 kite shields just to make it worthwhile. So obviously what I'm going to do next is search Guthix, and I'm going to go down through and find Guthix kite shield. Okay, I'm going to buy 10. Ooh, yeah, I'm just going to buy 10 for demonstration purposes. And since it went down, I got another tab pulled up. I recommend having 2 tabs pulled up. Since it went down 905 GP, which isn't bad at all, I am going to set the price for 480. Now, this doesn't really matter. Like, okay, here's a quick tip. If the price goes up more than 1K, you are going to buy either a little bit below, and when I mean a little bit below, I mean like 1K, 1.5K below market price, and this is if it goes above 1K, if it goes above 1K, I'd recommend buying 1 to 2K below, and that is if you get pretty lucky and you get it, but you will, there's a high chance you could get that since the item's worth 500K and you buy 1K below, it's no big deal. But if it goes up 5 to 10k, then I would suggest putting the value of the item up 8k, 8 to 10k above market, because the item's going to continue to increase, and if you're lucky enough, you could get a grand exchange update that updates it another 10k, and if you bought 10 of them, there's another 100k profit right off the bat. But just for this video, I'm going to buy them for 9,755 under market price. Let's just go 1 GP above that, just to overrule anybody that is 480,000 exactly. I recommend you always do that. I'd either go one above or one below, but in this case I'm just going to go one above. And I will be back when all of these buy. Alright guys, I'm back. So I let this offer sit in overnight, and I came on the next morning, and boom. And I recommend you do this. Make sure it sits overnight, or maybe throughout the day if you're not home and you're not playing, because it's really tedious if you like stay on and wait for all of them to buy. It just seems like it takes a lot longer than it actually does. So I got these for the original price, you know, 480,000 1 GP, like I said. So now we are just going to instantly put these back in here and see medium price. I can already sell for 9,756 GP more. But that would only give me a 90k prop. So I think I'm going to try and sell it for 4,99999. So and sell for that much, I think. That seems to be a good price. Now, since I just bought these, they're not going to sell for another 4 hours, I'd say. So I'll be back when that happens. So I'm back, guys, and I let these sit for about 2 hours, and they all sold for the price I set them at, 499,999. Again, I like to sell them 1 GP under an even number. So like 500,000, you sell them for 499,000, you know. It's like that. So let's see the profit amount for this. I made 100 and around 199K. Not bad for no work, and used less than 5 mil to do it. So if you got less than 5 mil, you got the potential here to, you know, make a good 200K really easily.